really trying to get something down onto Voivod early on. Has to pop the Ghost as well, but the Miasma goes down immediately because Scar is on the backside here. Wrigley just has to turn tail and run. So they're going to try to jump down onto Selfie. They want to get the fear off from Skara. Selfie, though, still utilizing his own Ghost. Scar's going to have to flash away, but he goes down. I didn't even see all that damage go through.
You have to be concerned now about a potential dive coming in, while, especially while Skara's up on the top side. But luckily for them, so is Wiggly.
Yeah, Wiggly potentially going to try to steal this blue buff or at least for Skara to get. Actually, Cosmic Binding goes down onto Revan. How did Revan lose all of his HP all of a sudden? A heal afterwards, the Ignite comes out as well. Revan taken down, but he's healthy enough to stay alive through the Ignite.
Unfortunately, unable to find that opening, and here comes Selfie.
Well, this is one of those roams we were talking about. Didn't happen in game one. He's trying to get it on in game number three here. He's able to pick up a kill on the I'm a Cutie Pie.
Delta Fox has gotten aggressive. That was a really nice trade onto Revan, but unable to find the kill. They end up down a couple summoners. They don't have a flash available. They find a kill. Now they want to roam back to the mid lane.
Well, Tahm Kench brings Selfie with him as well. Paralyzing Gaze only lands on the one, but a good flash over the wall from Voivod. Miasma follow after. A flash forward from Revan and the ace in the hole lands.
Big thing that's going on is Kwas is winning the top side on his own. We talked about potentially wanting to snowball there, but they found some opportunities around the mid lane. Once again, we also know that Templestorm loves playing around Selfie.
Oh, and actually the gravity field's gonna stop Skara's ultimate from going through. Actually, they don't want to use it. We're only on the Q. Tempered Fate comes in from Bard, stops Selfie from dealing some damage.
Wesley
still doesn't go down. Sheep in the meantime is gonna follow through, tries to flash forward to dodge out the Cosmic Binding, will still gobble up Skara and spit him out and actually seal the deal on the kill as well. Sheep, though, no great health left available. Voivod picks up a kill for himself. It's up to them. Right now, they're just continuously invading down, making sure that Delta Fox cannot see anything, such as them catching on the shifter right here. Explosive cast and make sure he doesn't use the Bard portal. Does wind up happening a little bit later on, though, but ace in the hole, not able to connect for the kill. Instead, Wiggly flashes forward and picks up shifter.
They know that this dragon's going to be a pretty big objective fight over. They land that. Meanwhile, on the top side, Dyrus getting jumped on.
Kwas getting a lot of damage down, but a hop away there from Dyrus. Cutie Pie, in the meantime, is all by his lonesome. Four members strong when Tempo Storm going down to him. And actually now, there's a Warwick chasing down on the Kwas. Does get it knocked back away from the hammer form of Kwas.
Cutie Pie is caught out in the bot lane all by himself.
You always want to bring a buddy. And so Voivod's bringing Shifter into the mid lane. And Miasma goes down. The Paralyzing Gaze down as well. And Selfie gets saved by Sheep. He brings his own buddy to the fray. But the Ignite's gonna tick down while Selfie's in the belly, and he winds up going down no matter what.
Members around the mid lane to make sure that that doesn't snowball into an objective, but now Dyrus wants to find opening onto Revan.
Ooh, a flash Gnar is flashed away there by Revan, but he's gonna get collapsed on now. Cutie Pie and Shifter. Shifter taking up the tower. A heal comes out here from Revan trying to get the kill. Actually, Shifter is the one that secures the kill there.
Looks like they're going to lose a mid lane turret, but they're going to keep trying to pick on Revan.
Yeah, Revan actually looks to be the focus here. Skara is going to want to go in for the Infinite Thrust, misses, but just is right into Cutie Pie. The fear is going to land, however, and even though the Culling is a couple shots wide to the left, they're able to pick up a kill onto Revan. The rest of Tempo Stormers responded by taking a tier 2 tower in the mid lane, so they've taken four towers now.
Does have a lot of really nice stuff, as once again, another opportunity.
Ooh, and Skara is going to want to pounce down onto Selfie in the mid lane, uses his own flash because Selfie has none for himself, and Voivod picks up the kill, so now comfortable 2-1-1 on the Voivod Cassiopeia.
Right after, they do have two very easy go buttons. Something that we said they might have lacked a little bit in their previous game was that while they did have a really nice team comp, it didn't really fit their style, that, where it's a super control focus. They had their best game in game one when they had the Kalista. It's a super important objective, not quite the level of Infernal, but you're going to take what you can get here, as they're looking like Cutie Pie might have been caught a little bit out of position.
Ooh, he went forward, didn't realize Wiggly was in that brush, but the rest of Delta Fox is collapsing on this one. Cutie Pie's able to stay alive. There's a teleport being channeled from top lane of Kwas as he took down that tower. Wiggly dropping about half HP. Tempered Fate comes in immediately on the Kwas. There's no damage coming out from the Jace, but as soon as that fades away, the fake Zanyas will give way to Kwas picking up a kill onto Skara. The favor of kills with Tempo Storm is now 7-6. The gold lead still heavily in favor of Tempo Storm, but Delta Fox matching them kind of blow for blow at this point in time. Now continuing to pressure down the Selfie, who while he's pushing, you know, kind of all by himself, is going to be exposed here. Voivod takes a large chunk of damage, though, and Tahm Kench has shown up with Wiggly. They wind up getting the Tempered Fate down on the Tahm. He's not able to really gobble up Selfie here until the absolute last minute, but Dyrus is coming in. He's ready to transform, but he's bringing Revan in with him. Gnar against the wall, picks up a kill on the Selfie. Paralyzing Gaze comes out as Voivod is healthy enough to rejoin the fray, as Wiggly's taking a lot of damage, and Wiggly will go down to the rampaging Voivod. Kill spoon fed to Kwas, so he's gonna be able to go kind of toe to toe with this Jace pickup for now. Uses the Gnar just kind of disengage on top of the boulder toss. Actually has C4 sees Selfie coming around the backside, tries to get a kill on the cross. I'd say Dire's having a pretty good game. He winds up going down, but Delta Fox making things happen on the opposite side of the map. Sheep's going to get caught out. He gets taken down as Cutie Pie picks up a kill for himself there.
Tempo Storm always trying to get caught out. Hold on, not quite done yet. Nice Bard ultimate.
Lands onto Revan in the follow-up. Kha'Zix binding the paralyzing gauges there as well, just to make sure he doesn't move whatsoever. 5-1-2 on Boy Boy's Cassiopeia. The rest of the team from the side of Tempo Storm shows up, Quad specifically. You see the recall is going out. Actually, Cutie Pie once again, taking a shot blast to the face, trying to bait Wiggly in to go forward with a body slam. Doesn't for Randu and Zomin complete it. Unable to land the slow AoE down onto Cutie Pie. But now Delta Fox.
Ooh, double
Cosmic
stun.
Binding lands onto both of the members here. A fear comes out from Scar as now it's going to be the Gragas separated and goes down. So even though Tempo Storm thought they were the ones that were routing Delta Fox picks up a kill. A sixth one for Boy Boy.
Cool. On this top river to try and get some vision control. This time around, Scar does land the Warwick ultimate.
Yep, presses down to Wiggly, who's going to get gobbled up by Tom Kent. The Tempered Fate's going to be, well, I think it's still one, as the spit out from Gragas is not spit him out in the Tempered Fate zone. Meanwhile, Tom Kent won it going down, so Delta Fox has picked up a kill, and a killing spree goes over the side of Cutie Pie. Quas, in the meantime, getting some tower damage down, as well as some Dyrus damage down. But is Delta Fox trying to go for a Baron or a fight around that at this point in time? Tempo Storm are just going to be pushing down on multiple fronts. They're taking down two inhibitors at the same exact time. Delta Fox, what if there's a response in order to do so? I don't even think they're doing the Baron at this point in time. They're trying to, but Wiggly all by himself is zoning them away. Tempo Storm are going to be taking the entire base if they can left alone for this one. Delta Fox finally gets the Baron. Now they lose a Nexus Tower at the same time. Wiggly pulling a hero play.
With how many turrets already down, though, the use case kind of drops to zero about the amount of times you can use that left in this game.
Both teams have two stacks of their elemental drakes, and actually Delta Fox starting this one up. They're going to trade Baron for Elder Dragon, it looks like here, as both teams are on opposite sides of the map. So Tempo Storm potentially looking for more of the fighting kind of style. Delta Fox may be looking for the pushing of the objectives kind of style. Actually, you might be catching down on the Dyrus. The Abyssal Voyage comes out, Selfie and Sheep down here. Dyrus going to gnar away. He turns back around for some reason, has to flash away out of the Chaos Storm. Selfie gonna get the speed boost from hitting a minion, but decides not to run away. Tempo Storm actually backs against the wall. The other one's being pushed in because of this Baron buff. You mentioned the Baron buff lasting longer than the Elder Dragon. Elder Dragon has been gone for a while. The Culling comes out. Tempered Fate lands on three people. This could be the fight that Delta Fox needs. The Cosmic Binding lands as well, and Scar goes in. What a big belly slam. Knocks them all back. Gargoyle Stoneblade has been popped, but so has Wiggly. Boy Boy goes legendary on the Cassiopeia. They pick up one kill, but can they break the base? And Delta Fox mentioning the Tempered Fate coming out from the shifter. They're all going to have a really good way to stop Tempo Storm from doing it. Actually, Quas trying to get the split push down. Once again, he's stopped up by the Tempered Fate himself. Has to run the QSS to get out of here. They're actually going to want to get the kill onto Quas. Now the Abyssal Voyage has come in. Cutie Pie has to try to flash over the wall. Shifter's trying to weed them on a wild goose chase, which could potentially open up Delta Fox to the Baron, but they're actually collapsing on the bottom side of the map.
Now Delta Fox is trying to force down this Baron without one of their biggest playmakers available. This could be very dangerous.
Yeah, this is very, very dangerous from Delta Fox. Quas is dead on the side of Tempo Storm, though, so they don't have a damage dealer. Scar is in the Baron pit, so the rest of Tempo Storm is here. Where's Cutie Pie? Cutie Pie's on the bottom side of the map. Delta Fox are in a 3v4 situation. They basically leash the Baron at this point. The Boy Boy's going to want to pick up a kill on Tom Kent, but Wiggly gets the Baron for themselves. Now Tempo Storm are trying to fight Delta Fox. Boy Boy pretty much all by himself now that Scar has gone down for a double kill. Cutie Pie's still split pushing in the bottom lane. He's picked up a kill on the inhibitor, but Delta Fox have lost more than half their team.
And Delta Fox opts into a split push situation despite
got the
superior
calling,
team fight.
Trying to trade on the Quas. Quas goes in. Cutie Pie taking low. Cutie Pie gets killed. Jace shuts him down! There's Baron buff in the mid lane!
And Tempo Storm's gonna try and push up right now. Boy Boy and Shifter are the only two alive. There's only one inhibitor turret down. Quas is gonna teleport in.
Quas is TPing in. There's one tower left alive. It's all up to Boy Boy and Shifter. Can they defend? The Tempered Fate's already been used. Shifter goes down! Boy Boy is surely gonna fall, but the Nexus falls first. And with that Baron call, with the split push, Delta Fox lose the series!